Virtual Home Visit for a Child with Medical Complexity, Medication Safety by Dr. Kathleen Huth in the Virtual Home Visit Working Group.
So this is what we call Jack's medicine cabinet, and we designed the island to meet these needs. So what we do in here is this, on this side is his liquid daily medication, and these are his pills and some of his nebulizers, and also this is the nebulizers, and this is extra syringes, that we use to administer the medication. Down here is the secondary supplies, things that we don't have to use daily, but sometimes they're PRN, so like Benadryl, etc. And then on the very bottom shelf, where we're required to have 90 day, through, you know, the pharmacy supplies, we're required to have most prescriptions be 90 days. This is where the rest of the spare medication goes as we go through it. So, and this is where we keep the extra extensions for his Mickey button, the extra button, medical tape, pill crushers, Marilax is back there too, anything that we could possibly need for Jack on a daily basis. And then what we do is we just take these trays out every morning or afternoon or evening and we move them over here. And this is our prep station. So this is where we keep the extra syringes, the nebulizer mask, the pill crushers, the measurers, because we have to measure the food, the Pedialyte, and we have his promote in the cabinet over there. So this is our total prep station. And then also in here, we have like our travel bottles. So when we're going on the road and we have to mix formula or any other stuff with the Pedialyte we take on the road. So it's very streamlined, and then we move, and this is just an example of some of the stuff we use for his morning medication, and this is all the syringes, so we put it in here, and then we wash, and then we can just move it right back over here, and when we're done, we just put it right back in the cabinet. And then it's out of the way, it's safe. If we have to lock it, we can. If we're having company or little kids around, we do that. You just don't want any accidents. And then this is the other cabinet we have to keep, because again, you have to keep monthly supplies, so we need Jack's Promo and his Pedialyte and stuff goes all in there. And then also some of his medication must be kept refrigerated, so he has a shelf. So this is his omeprazole that he has to take twice daily. We keep his suppositories cold because he also has to, we found them to be more effective, and he has to have one of those daily. And also the extra promote has to stay in there because once opens, refrigerated. So that is also what we need for Jack on a daily basis.
Jack has a complex medication regimen to manage different chronic conditions, based on recommendations from different members of his subspecialty team. Some medications are liquid form, others need to be dissolved or crushed. He receives medication through his gastrostomy tube, as well as inhaled medications. Medications are timed around his feeds, sleep, and school schedule. There are many factors that can increase the risk of medication error in children with medical complexity like Jack. Children with medical complexity are at higher risk of medication errors for many reasons. Polypharmacy, or the use of multiple medications to treat often more than one chronic condition, is very common. Children with medical complexity often have multiple providers in different clinical settings prescribing medications. They may use multiple pharmacies, depending on the different formulations that might be available. Medications may be given via different routes of administration, including orally, via an enteral tube, inhaled or nebulized medications, or through a central line. Medications may be changed frequently, particularly with transitions in care. It is essential to partner with families when reviewing, changing, adding, or discontinuing medications. Encourage caregivers to keep an updated list of medications and allergies with their child. Perform a medication reconciliation at every care transition. Include the dose and the volume, as medications may have different concentrations. Review potential drug interactions or possible contraindications with every new medication. For example, a new medication to manage spasticity might change the metabolism of an anti-epileptic medication, or a child with impaired kidney function might require a dose adjustment. Ensure safe medication storage and preparation. It is important to consider the child's daily schedule when establishing a new medication regimen. Consider what medications might need to be given at school, and consider the timing in relation to feeds or other medications. Considering what the child's day might look like when prescribing medications can support adherence. For example, in hospital, a nebulized medication may be given exactly every 6 hours around the clock, whereas at home it might be acceptable to give the medication in the morning, after school, and before bed, without waking the child from sleep to give an additional dose. Consider, what measures are in place to ensure medication safety for Jack? In Jack's home, there is a large space for safely storing medications that can be locked. He has consistent home nursing support and caregivers preparing, administering, and documenting his medications on his schedule. Some patients and families may not have these options available, and it is particularly important to consider the challenges that might be faced in ensuring medication safety in the home and community.